Good morning. Today we have to start with the introduction to paint window. As we know, paint is an application software that helps us to draw and paint. Here is the icon of paint. To open paint, we click on start button, go to all programs, then accessories menu, and finally we click on the paint option. Now, here is the paint window, how it looks like. Right at the top, we have the title bar, then the ribbon, and then the work area where we draw. One by one, we'll discuss all of them. Title bar. This is the title bar. At the top of the paint window, here we see the name and title paint. Along with that, we have some control buttons like minimize button. This button decreases the size of the window into a small icon on the taskbar. Then we have maximize button that increases the size of the window to maximum, means full size of the screen. Then close, it helps us to close the window. Redo, undo, and then save, the round rectangular box that helps us to save our file. We'll study about all these things in the later presentations. Now, next is the ribbon. Here you see the ribbon. Ribbon has different tools. Basically, all the tools are categorized under tabs. There are three tabs here: file tab, home tab, view tab. Under the tabs, there are different groups. As we can see, home tab, there are a group called clipboard, image, tools, shapes, and colors. Under every group, there are many options or tools. Okay, first we'll discuss the tools here, drawing tools. First is the pencil tool. It looks like a normal pencil. It helps us to draw and paint. Next is the paint can. It helps us to color the drawing. We click on paint can. We go to color palette. We choose the color and then we can color. Now next is a text tool. This tool helps us to draw a box where we can write. Then is eraser tool. If we do any mistake, we can erase with the eraser tool. Now color picker tool. It looks like a small tube. Here what happens, suppose we have two pictures, rectangle and a square. So if my rectangle is red color, I can pick that color and put it in my square as well. Means it copies the color of one picture to another. And the last one is looks like a magnifying glass. It helps to zoom the picture. It may look picture bigger. Next is the brush tool. It shows different styles of paint brushes. As you use watercolor, you draw, you paint with the paint brush. Same way, it shows you brushes with different thickness to draw. Along with that, we have different shapes in paint that we can draw. Like we have line tool, then we have curved line, then we have rectangle tool, we have stars. And here is something like cartoon characters speak, the small clouds. These are called the callouts. So not only this, along with that, you have outline that will help you to give the outline of the shapes that you enter. And not only this, you can also fill the shapes with different colors, red, blue, green. You can put different colors inside the shapes. So for that, we use the fill option. Next is our color palette. You see here, we see different colors with different boxes. First option here is size. The size will help you to decide how much thick line will be drawn outside. Suppose I draw a rectangle, how much will be the thickness of the sides of the rectangle? Or if I am using a pencil, so what will be the thickness of my pencil lead? These things are decided by the size option. Then we have color one. Color one shows us the color when we will write, which color writing it will come. If it is red, then it will be red. So if I am drawing a shape, so what will be the outside line of the shape color? So these colors we can select from the color palette just given beside. Second, color two, it shows you the background color. Means at the back, which color the page is there, or which color is going to be filled inside the boxes, or which color is going to be filled inside the shapes, that color is shown in color two. Same colors, same here also, you can choose the colors from the color palette. More edit colors are there. If you want more colors, different types of colors, you can create your own custom color using the here. Most important is use of mouse. We read about drawing, we read about colors, but how to do these things? Here we see a picture of mouse. A mouse has two buttons, right button and left button. One thing we must remember in paint, for doing anything, for drawing, for erasing, for choosing the color, we need the left button of the mouse. For drawing especially, you need to press, hold the left button and move your mouse. Then only your picture will be drawn on the page. For selecting also, we need the left mouse button. You go to the shape, you put the left, click the left mouse button, the shape will be selected, you come back, press the left mouse button and drag. Drag means move the mouse. Then only your picture will be drawn on the screen. For coloring also, you need to go and click on left button, then choose the color with the left button and then click on the picture, your picture will be colored. So left mouse button is very important. Next here we have selection tool. For other things other than drawing, like cut, copy, paste, for changing the size of the picture, for making the picture small, or any picture that is that has that part that is not needed by us, so we can delete that also. So for all this thing we need the selection tool. Okay, here also left click is working. You go with the left button of the mouse, click on it, then if once your selection tool is selected, you go to the picture, you choose the picture, and then you can crop, means the things that you don't want in the picture, unnecessary things of the picture, you can cut it, you can resize, you can change the picture size, and we can rotate also, move the picture left, right, like that. Next here you see, once we select the picture, we can cut the picture. Cutting means a small portion you delete, take it away, then copy. Copy always, we know, copying the picture. Whatever we cut or copy, we can paste with the paste option. This is clipboard group. Next is your view tab. In view tab, we have very few options. Zoom in and zoom out. As the name suggests, zoom in means it makes the picture bigger and bigger. Zoom out, smaller and smaller. 100% makes the zoom 100%, maximum zooming. Then ruler, it has to see the ruler or hide the ruler. Grid lines, it has to see the grid line or hide the ruler line. Grid line. Status bar, it shows to hide the status bar or show the status bar. And then finally, full screen. It will see, view the picture on the full screen. Full computer screen, you can see the picture. So these were the tools. So that's all for today. Now we will learn in the next video how to work with Paint.